Hello there, and welcome to Scotland. Well, I wish you were true. Anyway, we are here and enjoy the Scottish Summit, as I'm sure you guys are all doing. Well, today is a session about content moderation. Content moderation in Microsoft Teams with an extension also to SharePoint. Content moderation because we need it. We need it in case we want to review different topics, different messages, different images. What content moderation does basically is the possibility to look into potentially offensive images, to filter for profanity, to moderate adult or racy content, and to check for personally identifiable information of POI. So before we start, my name is Stefano Tempesta. I'm a senior program manager at Microsoft in the Azure Confidential Computing Program Group. But as said, today we are going to talk about Microsoft Teams. Thanks to the organizer for putting together this amazing event, and thanks for the sponsors for making it possible. So let's look into content moderation now. Content moderation is part of the Azure Cognitive Services. There are so many cognitive services that you can use: vision, speech, knowledge, search, language. But specifically today, we'll focus on the decision cognitive service. Decision is a service that can enable different decisions, detecting an anomaly. Content moderation, which is the one that we're going to focus on today, and a few other things around advice and personalization. So let's focus on content moderation. As said, image moderation, text, video, and there is even a human review tool, so that is completely offline, that there are some people behind, you upload some text, images, videos, and the moderators, the human moderators, will review and flag and tag so that you can use them later. But obviously in this context we are going to use the machine learning power content moderation, which process images, text, and videos in real time. Where do we start from? Well, we start from the Azure portal. We need to create a content moderator service in there, which we will then use in Logic Apps or in Power Automate to connect to Microsoft Teams. So let's look into the Azure portal and see how to create a content moderator service. Here we are in our Azure portal, and we start from the Azure Marketplace, obviously. So the first thing you want to do is probably look into AI and machine learning. This is where you can see there are different services, but let's expand and find all the available cognitive services which are grouped in here, and you can see you will find content moderator in this as well. Another way probably is just to create a new resource and search for content moderator, and you will very likely go in the same place. So let's do that. Open content moderator, which is here. So click on create content moderator. This open your wizard to create content moderator. You need to provide the subscription, a resource group, or create a new resource group, a region where you want to deploy the content moderator itself, and there are obviously several regions that are supported in Azure. Give it a name and pick a price tier. So you can start from the incredible price of $0, so free tier, where you have a limitation of one call per second, which is plenty for testing purposes. Then obviously if you want to scale to a production ready service, you need to go for the standard tier, which allows for 10 calls per second. And I'm going to talk about pricing in a moment, or later in this session, but obviously you can see the full pricing details just there in the Azure portal. Just click on it. Depending on the region, you will see a pricing for this specific service. That's all you need to do. Review and create. It takes really a few minutes to generate the content moderator. I have already done before, so I'm going to use the one that is already in my system. So I'm now open my content moderator service that I previously created, and obviously you have the full Azure portal experience with an overview which identifies the location where it's been deployed, the subscription, the endpoint, the pricing tiers, and so on. From here, the very, very important thing that you can do is to manage keys and endpoint, because using this specific key that is associated to this service, you can then connect to Logic Apps or Power Automate, whatever is your preferred tool. So in here, so click on keys and endpoints on the left hand side, you can see there are different keys, there are an endpoint and a location. We are going to use the key for connecting in Logic Apps, which is the tool I'm going to use today. So just make sure that you copy the key to the clipboard, and you can then use it when connecting to Content Moderator from Logic Apps. Alright, so let's have a look at Microsoft Teams. I have a company team and I have a channel, a moderated channel. Forget the previous messages. I've obviously been practicing before this session, for preparing this session. So I'm going to create a new conversation here and enter some PWI, some personal identifiable information. This can be my email address, or my phone number, or social security number. Now, I don't live in the US, I don't have a social security number, but I do have an email address, so I'm gonna use this. And hey there, Scottish Summit folks, if you want to get in touch, please write me at stefano@powercommunity.com. Alright, so gonna press here, and there is a flow that is running behind, and this flow will check for messages that are coming inside this specific channel. And obviously I'm gonna show this flow in action in a moment. So are we ready? I'm going to press send. Here we go. Alright, so let's see what happens. I'm gonna hold on for a few seconds. The flow will trigger quite soon, and send a reply to this message. Here we go. Well, that an email has been detected. How that works? Let's have a look now at the flow in Power Automate. So here we are in Teams content moderation in Power Automate. Let's edit this flow. As you can see, there are the usual actions, or the trigger and the actions that you would expect. When a new channel message is added, this is a Teams action that it triggers when in a specific team, in a specific moderated channel, a new message is added, as I've just done before. And then I'm going to call the detect profanity and match against custom and share blacklist action. This is something that you can find in Content Moderator, so I'm gonna show you in a moment. It's here, and an action, search for Content Moderator. Here we go, pick this Content Moderator here, and you can see there are several actions here. Now, I'm not really detecting profanity in this case, but PII falls under this action here, detect profanity, okay? Obviously, I could enter profanity and it will be detected there, but I'm not gonna do it because we are recording this video. Here we go. So in here you choose a few options. Now this one is already there, so let me get rid of this action and show the one that I've already entered. So text is the message body that we get from the previous step, so from the channel from the message in the channel in Teams. And then I can enter a few other parameters. If I don't enter any language, it would default to English, otherwise there are multiple languages that are supported. The important thing in this case is that I pick yes for the PII parameter. I could even specify a custom list of words to detect. So this is to create a custom vocabulary of words to detect that I want to moderate. And the classification looks, so the classify input, yes, looks for profanity, racy content, and a few other flavors that I'm not going to use in this example anyway. And then I move along. There may be one or more of these items detected. So I apply a loop that for each, in this case, personal identifiable information that has been detected, I'm going to send a reply. Now there are two ways that I can do this. I can send a reply that will come out with my own account. So you can see it was email detected, and then the variable that the personal identifiable information detected email address, and then obviously I can compose the message the way I want, or I can post it also. So I'm going here, pick Teams, going to Microsoft Teams, and you can see I can post a reply to a message, which is the action that I have used, or I can also post a message as a flow bot. In that case, the flow bot will show as a main message and not as a reply. There is an example in the channel, so I'm going to show that in a moment. But I'm not using this, I'm just using the post a reply to a message, and that's my entire flow. Okay, so if you're interested to the flow, I'm happy to share it. Get in touch, it's easy. I can export it and make it available for you to use it. All right then, so back in here, you see that there was a flow here. This was another example for another time where I detected the email address using the flow. In this case, I'm using the action to reply to the message. Now let me do one more try just to show you how smart is this service. So I'm going to create another conversation and I try to work around this limitation. Okay, oops, try that. So let's assume that I've been detected and been reported for sharing some personal information. So try that. Stefano at as at powercommunity.com. So I'll try to disguise my email address. What's going to happen now? Now, the beauty of this content moderator is that it doesn't just look for a word matching, for pattern matching, but for some machine learning power moderation, so activities that detect also email address, credit cards, IP addresses, street addresses, even when they are in a format that is trying either to hide it, disguise it, or not really, really obvious. Now, in this case, it's probably obvious to a human, but to a machine, this is trying to hide the email address, in this case, is still being detected. Okay, let's change scenario now and move into SharePoint. At the end, the context and the examples are similar. We are still using Content Moderator. We are still using some capability of checking for content, which is using in another scenario. So here we are. I have a site and I have a folders. I have a kids folders that at the moment is empty, and I'm going to upload some pictures of some kids. These are stock images, so all good to go. So I have here some pictures. Let's say let's pick these with a mom with two girls, very likely, and I'm going to upload in here. So, file uploaded. I'm gonna close this for a moment and let's see what happens. There is a flaw again. So, this time I wrote in LogicApps, so I'm gonna show it in a moment. That is running and checking for images uploading to this specific folder. In a moment, it shouldn't take too long, we will see what happens. Here we go. We have a blur kids image. So what happened exactly? Well, the kids image is the one that we have seen here. And then if I look into the blur one, the content moderation has detected face in the picture. Well, but not just any face, face of underage of kids in this case, and blur that face. Pretty powerful. Right? So let's have a look how to build a flow for moderation like this one. I'm gonna close this and go into my Azure portal one more time. Here we go. I have a kid's face blurring. This is in Logic Apps. So open the designer and let's follow the steps. It's a bit long, so I'll try to focus on a few key aspects. Well, the first one is when a file is created in this specific folder, then I'm going to share this file using a public link. The reason I'm going through OneDrive is that my SharePoint is locked down for public access, so I'm going to copy the file in a temporary folder in OneDrive and create a public link for anonymous access. But obviously, if your SharePoint is configured for public access, you don't have to go through this workaround. The important part is to detect a face, and the reason that I have to go through a share link is because the detect faces action requires a web URL. It doesn't work with content to upload, so I cannot upload the body of the image. I need to go through a URL. Here we go. Now, for each detected face, I'll check the condition if it is less than 18 years old. So the beauty of this detected face is that it returns a number of variables that you can see here. You can see facial hair attributes, the rectangle where the face is being recognized, eyes, eyebrows, mouth, nose, a lot of things, right? And it also detects the age, obviously an approximation of the age. So if the age is less than 18, so I'm going to the true branch, get the contents from OneDrive, call a function for doing the Gaussian blurring, and then save the blur file as blurred. Set the variable that the kit has been detected and then close the loop in some way. Again, happy to share the flow. Just get in touch. It's all easy to use once you get familiar with the different steps. All right, so another powerful capability here is the detect faces. And to do this, you just have to go one more time into content moderation. Content moderator. Okay, and from here you will be able to find face in an image content. Super easy, super powerful. And from there, obviously, there is your own logic, what you want to do with those faces that have been detected inside the image. All right, let's say is SharePoint, just to keep it simple, the same concept works also in Teams, obviously. Let's check for adult or racy content. Now, this obviously is quite sensitive, so I have to be very wary of what I'm sharing here. For some reason, a picture of a woman in a bikini is considered racy. So if I'm gonna upload this in here and check now for a flow that is running, which I'm going to show you in a moment as well. That's the flow. When a file is created in a folder, so I'm gonna check for, let's go to the designer mode, is better. When is in the shared document, check if an image contains racy or adult content. And again, here you do the same. Add an action, going to content moderator, and there are different actions here. We are reviewing image contains racy or adult content. Okay, here we go. So just pass the file content that you have obtained at the step before. And then I initialize a variable. Is racy? Boolean. Is adult? I create a variable body, which I'm going to use to generate this JSON file. This JSON file contains these properties here. Okay, for adult and racy. And then I basically create a file named after the picture.log, which parse that JSON file and input or write whether an image is classified as adult or racy, and also the score, okay? Because there is a score of classification between 0 and 1, 0 being not detected and 1 totally detected, okay? So this is the flow. Let's run it. Go back to SharePoint, and you can see there is a log file that has been generated. So this log file, as you can see, read is not adult in the sense of adult that you can imagine, but is a racy content. There's a bit of a bias here. I haven't tried with a picture of a man in bikini. Maybe I should. Who knows? But yes, the model here detect this picture with a very, very high level, so nearly one, so 100% of being a racy content. Questionable, but that's the model that has been trained for these specific content moderator services. So that's all I wanted to share with you. The use of the Content Moderator API, starting from Azure and then connecting in Logic Apps or Power Automate with Microsoft Teams, SharePoint, and obviously any content management, any system that is connected through Logic Apps or Power Automate, one of those hundreds of connectors can be used for the purpose. There are some limits in the API itself, as you see on the screen. So when you use the API for content moderation of images, you have to make sure that the image is not too small, at least 128 pixels, which is the bare minimum just to have some sort of details to analyze in the image, but also not larger than 4 megabytes, which is not much if you use a smartphone with a very high resolution, to be honest. If you are analyzing for text instead, you want to make sure that your text to be analyzed is not longer than 1024 characters. We have seen at the very beginning when creating the service in the Azure portal that you have a free tier and a standard tier. For the free tier, there is no support, there is no SLA, as you can expect. For the standard tier, the paid for tier, You have a 3 nines of uptime guaranteed, so 99.9% of SLA. And speaking of pricing, the free tier is one transaction per second up to 5,000 per month, and the standard tier is 10 transactions per second, and the price, as you can see, decreases the more transactions you use. So over 10 million of transactions attract a cost of 40 cents per thousand of transactions, and unless you're building the next social networks, so it's probably unlikely that you hit millions and millions of transactions. To get started, start from Cognitive Services, the landing page for the Azure Cognitive Services, just to have an overview of the capability of the Cognitive Services in general, and then you may want to go a bit more in detail into Content Moderator. On the Content Moderator docs, you can find all the examples and source code, and obviously the documentation of the APIs that have been used. And feel free to get in touch directly with me through Twitter at Stefano Tempesta or on LinkedIn, and happy to share experience, share the source code, and whatever you feel like. No, just having some ideas for the next new app for content moderation in SharePoint, in Teams, or whatever you fancy doing it. So thank you very much for attending this session. Hope you enjoyed and find it inspiring. Enjoy the rest of Scottish Summit, and see you sometimes around. Bye.